So we'll call the meeting to order. This is the City of Greensburg Board of Aviation Commissioners Monthly Meeting. Be the fourth Monday every month at City Hall. We'll start by a roll call vote. Before we start that, I will say Jim Pruitt did send me a message that he will be here, but might be a few minutes late. We'll go ahead and proceed, Judy, if you'll do the roll call, please.
Don Whipple.
Here.
Boris Reese.
Here.
Bill Armistice.
Here.
John Doolittle.
Here. Of course, we'll also note present is Don Manley from BFNS, our airport manager, Jerry Schreiber, also present. You have the agenda before us, and I understand we have some changes or additions to make.
Under old business, we need to add Hangar H, budget, vegetation. Where we putting it? Under old business. It may be first or right after the update on the new jet system.
So Hangar H, the budget, and vegetation removal. Three items, one after another under them. Does anybody else have any modifications to the agenda? Anything? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept the agenda as modified.
So moved.
Aye.
Don moves or seconds. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, we've got a, we have an agenda now. And Judy Kurt, if you'll read the minutes from our previous meeting, June 23rd.
City of Greensburg, Indiana Board of Aviation Commissioners, Monday, June the 23rd, 2014. President John Doolittle called the meeting to order at 7 p.m. Roll call was taken. Board members present were Don Whipple, Jim Pruitt, Bill Armistice, Boris Reese, and John Doolittle. Don Manley, BFNS, Jerry Scheidler, Airport Manager, and Airport Assistant Manager Bernie Green were also present. Judy Kirk performed the duties of Secretary. Agenda approval. The meeting agenda was reviewed. The agenda was approved unanimously by voice vote. Minutes. Judy Kirk read the minutes from the May 27th regular meeting. A motion was made by Jim Pruitt and Don Whipple seconded that the minutes be accepted as read. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 5-0. Financial report. Bill Armistice read the airport financial report. Old business. Update on new Jet A fuel system installation. Jerry Scheidler reported that the new Jet A fuel system tank, startup, and training are complete and the equipment is operating properly. Don Barr Moran Estate Settlement. John Dooley reported that the final settlement agreement paperwork for the Moran Estate is not yet complete due to the unavailability of one of the parties. Don Manley with BFNS. Don Manley presented the BFNS contractual agreement for inspection services for the terminal taxiway and apron overlay. Bill Armistice motioned and Jim Pruitt seconded the motion to accept the contractual agreement. The motion was approved unanimously by roll call vote 4-0. Boris Reese abstained because he was not present at the last meeting and had not received a copy of the agreement to review. Don Manley reviewed the checklist for bids. There were four bids submitted. Don Manley opened and reviewed each bid. All were in order and as submitted, and each participating company offered a bid bond of 5%. None offered an alternate bid for hot in-place recycling. Following is a summary of the bids submitted. O'Mara Paving, North Vernon, Indiana, for a total of $74,682.55. Milestone of Columbus, Indiana, a total of $121,081.30. Globe Asphalt of Indianapolis, Indiana, total of $105,595.15. Hall Road Company, Aurora, Indiana, total of $132,287.75. Don Manley will review the bids and make a recommendation at the next BOAC meeting. Don will also prepare and submit the grant application documents to the FAA by July 11, 2014. Bill Armistice made a motion and Boris Reese seconded a motion to allow John Dooley to sign the grant application when it is complete. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 5-0. This motion is for the grant application only and does not in any way imply approval of any of the bids presented. It was noted by Don Manley that the airport will be shut down for 3 days for paving. He also stated that the grant application will contain a copy of the terms and conditions this time. has some changes in their content. One such change was that airport employees must advise all parties driving on the airport property that they must not text while driving. Don also reported that the AOPA fly-in held on May 30th and 31st was a great success and that 537 aircraft had landed during the fly-in. He also announced that the AOAA quarterly meeting will be held on Thursday, July the 17th in Winchester, Indiana. New business, payment of bills. After discussion, Jim Pruitt made a motion and Horace Reese seconded the motion to approve the bills as submitted. The motion carried by roll call vote 5-0. Comments from the board. Don Whipple mentioned that he was very happy with the three recent articles printed by the Greensburg Daily News. Don, as well as other board members, complimented the author of the articles, Boris Ladwig, on doing an exceptional job in addressing the issues concerning the airport expansion project. Board President John duly noted that Phil Goddard, owner of the property adjacent to the airport, was present and welcome to the meeting. Mr. Goddard spoke briefly and asked a question about the supposed tree obstacles located on his property near the airport runway. John duly explained that the FAA had raised the question and that the trees were an obstruction, but that the board had not received a response from the FAA. There being no further business before the board, Don Whipple made a motion and Miller is the second that the meeting be adjourned. The meeting passed unanimously by voice vote and President John duly adjourned the meeting at 7:47 p.m. The next meeting is scheduled for Monday, July 28, 2014 at 7 p.m. at City Hall in Greensburg, Indiana.
Okay, there's the minutes. Any, do you have any questions or anything about the minutes? If not, we'll accept a motion to accept the minutes as read, as written.
So be.
Horace, motion.
Second.
Second by Don Whipple. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Passes unanimously. So, Judy, good job with that. Thank you. Appreciate it. Financial report. Bill, you want to read the financial report figures, please?
Airport Improvement Fund has $65,281.84. Borrowing Fuel Fund, $71,056.84. Airport Operations, $132,196.69 for a total of $268,535.37.
I'll make another, just a few comments about the figures that are before you there. In the first account, the 815 account, you notice revenue of $30,000 and change. The $30,000 was the check deposit from the Moran Estates. Disbursements show $38,000 plus. Bill, you said that's from the payment for the Jackson County Bank for our original purchase. And you'll notice disbursements for the Aviation or Refuel Fund are high this month only because we filled up that new Jet A fuel tank we bought. It didn't come with free fuel, but that's all right.
Shucks.
Have we had some crop dusters flying in and out of there?
Yeah,
that's good.
We have, yeah.
Yeah,
it's time for that. So, okay, that takes us to old business. First, listen here, just to update on the new Jet A fuel system. It's pretty much complete, like you said last week. But Jerry, can you say it's basically it's been active and working?
Yeah, it's been active. We've never had another tank of fuel put in today.
Wonderful.
So we was down to 2,600 gallon last Friday, and that, if they stay crop dusting, that won't last too long. So
no.
We filled it up today, and there wasn't any activity that I know of today, but Milhan applicators called today and said they had two planes here tomorrow operating again. So we're also getting some sales again from the helicopters that used to stop in and get it. They're coming again, and of course the COVID fertilizer using it. So it's been pretty active here so far.
Good. So, system's all working.
What's the item Todd wants to put over his plane?
Some type of a protective pad. You can basically some type of pad with a hole and you put it around the filler neck on the airplane so you got the nozzle there, you won't scratch your paint on the airplane wing. He mentioned it'd be nice if we would get one or two of those and have them there for people to use. So I don't know what the cost or anything else about it.
We got some place to store them out of the weather.
Well, he said that we need to like find somewhere to hang them there underneath the cover of the, on the tank itself, so it'd be right there where people can see them and know that they're what they're for and use them. So.
Is that something other facilities provide?
I have no idea. I've never seen it myself, but,
I think we ought to check with AvFuels, see if they.
He said that some AvFuel would have, be able to get from them, of course, they probably don't want something for them. That's how they generally do it.
Gee, I think it'd be a good service. Not only for him, but for everybody else that comes in and wants some.
Because you're, while you're standing there, news on Hangar H, which was the?
Hangar H, it has been rented on a month-to-month basis at the $500 a month.
For airplane?
Yes.
Okay.
That's the number one requirement. No, we have a fellow, and he's actually been on the list for several years, if, the hangar of the same size that Norm Schlemmer uses, if he ever moved out of there, he would want first chance at that hangar. So this new building, the Haran hangar, is the same size. And, when it actually officially became available where we could do something with it now, had him come down, look it over, and, he agreed to, you know, go ahead and rent it, at least see if it works out for him, which I'm sure it's going to, once he gets moved in, so they don't like it.
What's not to like?
Yeah, so like he said, that's a really nice hangar, so once he's seen it, you know, he was pretty much sold he wanted to rent it, so.
Good.
Any other questions for airport manager? Oh, thank you, Jared.
Okay.
All right. That takes us to, the budget, Bill.
City clerk treasurer's office sent this out to everybody, I believe. I don't know if you ever got it opened or not. Well, I didn't get around till about the last day to talk to, Don about it.
Did you get it?
It really.
Didn't get it.
Didn't get it? She emailed it to everybody, but it sensed it anyway. I like the way it looks, and if you want, maybe the next week or so I can meet with Don and we'll go over it and see if we want to change it. They've taken a lot of the lines out that just get zeros in them every year anyway, but it looks pretty good to me. I'll sit down with you next week or sometime.
That's fine.
Or even this week.
Whenever we.
Yeah, and then we can present it formally to the board next week, next month.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. That takes us to the next item under old business. Is that old or new business?
Actually, it's old, because we talked a little bit about it last time.
All right. The vegetation removal. So, we did have Don Manley maybe will help us with this. We did have a meeting with the NDOT at the airport. It was July 9th. Bill and I were there, Marty Blake, and was it Marcus Dyle, was that his name?
Jim. First time I met him.
Couple guys from NDOT, Marty Blake was one.
Your inspector, Jim. First name is Jim.
Yeah.
I can't remember his last name.
James.
What?
James.
James?
He's letting me know it's James.
James.
Bill and I were there, Jerry was there. Don, do you want to tell us a little bit about the substance of that meeting?
Okay.
If you would.
You all have pictures of to show what we're talking about. I'll get you a set for the record. Yes.
The meeting is a direct result of getting the 5010, noticing some differences in the 5010 that have been corrected already or need to be corrected in order to expedite the grant program. And so we set up the meeting, they flew down and we sat down and talked about obstructions in the approaches. And it was a very good meeting. They had some good suggestions. And for that, I prepared a notice of planning error proposal, so the FAA Form 7480, to correct the issues that are in the 5010. Now, for those that don't know what a 5010 is, it's the Airport Master Facility Record. And what it is it looks like this. Pass this around. Facility record. And the area of concern are the areas that talk about at the bottom in the remarks section. And as we noticed getting into the meeting, there were some marking changes need to be made. Yellow paint needs to be made white. correction and displaced threshold on the north end. So I developed the notice linear proposal, which John has already signed with the correction on the back. And some of these corrections that are stated are, Bill is working on with the two joining land owners on the side.
I've contacted all three.
Okay, that's all three of you on the north end as well?
Well, one on the north end, I haven't kind of, we have the determination of what trees need to come out on the John Henry property.
Yes, I need to, I'm gonna talk to you about that.
Okay.
That's on the things to do list I've got. So I have John sign that, I'm gonna forward that plus a drawing to your FAA program manager, and he'll take it from there. The drawing is basically just an overlay of your existing airport layout plan on an aerial. So that drawing, pass that around as well, I only have one copy. And I will make copies and bring and send them down so that you have all the board members. It was noted by the state that the only way we could make a change to the 5010 is by submitting the 7480 form. And I confirmed that with Mike Perry, the program manager of the FAA.
And they specifically want certain vegetation removed or cleaned up. And also, we have yellow paint at the north end of the runway on the runway markings that needs to be painted white by Bill's. We're gonna take care of getting white paint for that.
I've got white paint, but we might just get a roller and do it easier. Mike, this is a note that on the south end, the Goddard property, during the environmental study, it was designated to be a wetland by the engineer Neil Bennett. Since it's a wetland, we cannot take out the stumps or anything. We can cut the trees down to level. And I've been in contact with Phil Goddard and George Ringer both. George does the farming on it. And if they want to cut the trees down, take the limbs off, just get rid of all that along with the fence row up to Mary Bennett's and Goddard's. The Goddard's have no problem. Mary Bennett has no problems. We've got Pete Drittkamp looked at it, but we have to go back to him because I think we asked him to take the stumps out.
Right.
Being a wetland, the stumps cannot come out. And then, did Johanna get to look at it?
He looked at it, I've not heard back yet.
Okay. We will be getting something back from those two. And by the next meeting, we should be able to tell you how much it costs to remove it. And trimming the fence row out would be easier to take care of, just be mowed instead of growing up and the bushes cut down each year and whatever. On the Fred Sturgey property at the north end, there is no fence row. It's already been taken out, and he has no problems with the trees being taken out as long as they're taken, destroyed, and the brush taken care of. And that leads us up to the next tree, which would be John Henry's, which is over towards the railroad. And I'm not sure. You'll have to tell us which one that is. I'm not sure. And looking at the GSI map, who owns it? I don't know if it's railroad or his.
Right.
I hope it's railroads.
This is for the file that the wetlands are talking about.
Also, while I'm on the subject, at the south end of runway 18, or at the start of runway 36, approximately a half an acre, and we have to buy from Mary Bennett each year, and no crops going on at all. It has to be kept mowed down, no soybeans or corn. And looking at it, to be fair with her, I would think we should be able to pay her $150 a year to not use anything on that property. And the main reason they said it was they didn't want machinery on it.
Right.
This is what we're coming into land.
What Marty Blake did.
Yeah.
Because we don't buy the property, we just pay her to keep it clear, no crops.
Yeah, we'll mow and keep it down.
There's soybeans there down, and the people from NDOT said we can go ahead and allow them to finish it this year and harvest them, no corn. And next year they don't see anything there.
Mm-hmm.
what's the going rate for rental roof?
Property in that area, I really don't know. Rieger's farm out has the Goddard's, so I really don't know. Since the last, we used to pay her $100 an acre, and I think we just did half of it, didn't we, Jerry?
It wasn't all of it, yeah. So many roads they couldn't.
Yeah. And so I thought that, you know, we'll be taking at least three times from what we took before.
Do you know what we're taking?
We, approximately the area. Did I give you one?
Yeah.
He showed the blue section around her property.
Oh, the blue section?
Yeah. Now, that goes down to the end of the runway, but then you can see where, I hope you can see it anyway. Can you show up down the blue section? That's her property, and it's almost a half an acre.
This one?
She's.
This is Goddard.
Yeah. It's right here. She's not on her runway, is she?
No, she's the end of the runway though. Out at the end.
She goes up to this one there.
Okay.
This is property, her property, basically.
Changing that.
Is that an acre?
Pretty close. Or just a little less than an acre.
It's a half an acre.
Half an acre?
And it don't require us to take all of it, but it wouldn't be, it'd be difficult for her to take just what they require. Do they want all of it? Okay, here. Okay.
Well, some of that's on Goddard's land.
No. Well, the line's on Goddard's land, but I'm just talking about the end of the runway for Mary.
You're right.
Mary Benton.
It's Mary Benton's crops there. She's got soybeans there now.
Property line between Benton and Goddard, that's where we're changing. That's property. That's the Goddard property. There are trees. Cutting the trees down, but you're not changing the property.
Bill?
Yes.
Question I have, we will enter into a contract with them before we cut anything off their property, do you want?
We will have a signed agreement, yes.
And they've all been.
Phil Goddard came down last.
Wednesday.
Wednesday, and we went down and looked at all of it. I talked with Mary Benton on it. I talked to Fred Sturgeon about it. They have no problems with it. It's fine with them. We take the fence row out. It'll make it look better, and it would actually, I think, will help Goddard's out there, because you take some of the stuff, take moisture from their vegetation. It'll make it grow better, get a little more sunshine and everything else. And I'll have a price for you at the next meeting. We decide on who we want to rework. And we plan on having it done before December 31st of this year, but after crops are off the ground. After the crops have been harvested.
This is something that has to be done to keep our airport open, is that right?
Don?
The reason I'm asking this is that this seems like a waste of money if we're gonna build a new runway.
I don't disagree.
Yes, it seems like we discussed that.
Putting it off and putting it off and putting it off.
The grant program is the reason why this came up.
Okay.
From Washington down, they're filling back down on any conditions of obstructions, any approaches on any 5010. They're turning the grants back.
I guess Washington's wasting a lot of our money we can't do.
It's a good point, though. I mean, you know.
We just seem to keep putting it off. And I hate to spend bad or good money where it doesn't need to be. That's the only reason I'm asking. But if it's a requirement of the grant, then let's go for it.
Well, it's actually a state requirement as well. So, I mean, just having the airport open, the state requires you to have the approaches clear.
Well, I realize that, Don.
So.
Okay.
Okay, anything else on vegetation or Google? We come over there or vegetation? That'll take us over to new business. We'll go first into payment of bills. Don, we'll get back with you on that in just a moment, please. takes us to the bills. You've all have those listed in front of you here. In reviewing those, just in case there's any questions, there's a bill here from KFAB for $345, and that was...
That's the stainless steel box we used to close the news or throw the face in.
Right. Protect the road face, so everything else looks rather ordinary. Any discussion about the bills before us? We'll give you a moment to settle your...
Are you guys getting, which emails is that you get?
I got this one.
No, I didn't get them, Bill.
You didn't get them?
Nope.
Take you a moment to review that. Everything looks, to me, looks pretty ordinary.
Commissioner Dooley, may I suggest in the future, when she sends those out, ask for a receipt on that. That way, we can find out how often you check your computer, and if you don't get the receipt on it in so long a time, maybe she can reset it, try it again, or give you a call, see what's happening. Because it's important that you receive this information.
Yeah.
That work?
I'm sorry, Gary, I didn't get it all.
If she could, when she sends it, to ask for a receipt on it, that you received it, just click on that you received it.
Sure.
And if she don't get that back in a certain period of time, then she can resend it or contact and see if there's a problem. But we need to know about how long you guys think we should go before she calls you after she sends them.
Yeah. I know I got mine. You got yours?
Mine.
Boris got his. Jim?
Yeah, I got mine 7/23.
No, I haven't looked at my email. I've been out of town.
I've been looking for them.
Okay. Well, maybe, you know, when I bring these bills to them on tomorrow,
yes,
make sure they get to you.
Yeah, if you can come up with a certain amount of time, you know, 24 hours or something, you know.
24 hours.
Whatever's good for you guys.
24 hours.
Okay. Any discussion about the bills before us? Do you need any more time to review here? Add up. Okay.
I make a motion to pay them.
Morris has a motion to pay. Have a second to pay. Miller's just a second. Any further discussion before we take a vote? If not, Judy, roll call vote, please.
Don Buckle?
Yes.
Horace Reese?
Yes.
Bill Armistice?
Yes.
Jim Pruitt?
Yes.
John Doolin?
Yes. So that takes care of the bills. Next on the agenda, Don Manley, back up to bat, a few items to cover. Don's for Butler Fair and Seaford, our engineer for our airport.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the board. We held a pre-award meeting with the apparent low bidder, Dave O'Mara of North Vernon, for the taxiway and apron project that's coming up that we sent in an application for federal reimbursement on. And that pre-award meeting, I think, satisfied all issues. One of them was concerned that they were so much lower than the rest of the bidders, and that they were willing to honor their bid. They were perfectly happy with what they got. They reviewed everything and everything was go. And I expressed that in that meeting, talking about issues that occurred on the past project to make sure that more bids responsible, more responsible than they were in the first place during the runway project, because they did do the runway project. There were some areas of concern on that, specifically some milling areas on the longitudinal joints were not matching up properly, and there was ponding water. They're going to correct this. So anyhow, it was a meeting went along on conversation of the project, and so officially handed, I can't remember what the bid Bill or John, I handed the, my official recommendation of award at that time, that day, and I have a copy of it, which I'll read into the records now. We have reviewed the four bid proposals and found discrepancies as noted within the enclosed tabulation of bids. However, no discrepancies were found in the low bidder's Dave O'Meara Contractors proposal. We also confirmed Dave O'Meara Contractor Incorporated and subcontractor CE Hughes Milling Incorporated are not on the exclusion list as suspended, debarred, or declared ineligible for participation in federally funded projects. Therefore, we recommend the subject project be awarded to Dave O'Meara in the total base bid amount of $74,682.55. By copy of this letter, we request the FAA concurrence of the award. The award shall be subject to funding availability, FAA concurrence award, and acceptance of FAA grant offer. And then I enclose a copy of the bid packets. I hand deliver the original bid packets here. Exclusion, search documents, and the tabulation of bids enclosed. The original bid packet was returned on July the 9th. So, and that's the date of the letter, signed by me. And the board will need to make an official award subject to the way I stated in the recommendation report sometime now or in the future prior to the receipt of the grant. Or even after the receipt of the grant, actually prior to the notice of proceed or signing executed contracts. So you have some time, but you can make it subject to this right now and go forward. So we have questions on that part?
We have the engineer's recommendation to accept the very good job with Jerry Shire. You spoke with their representative that came out. Had a lot of concerns. You kind of went over a lot of things with them in detail. Do you have any special concerns now or anything to add?
I think we're going to be okay. You know, as long as I'm going to be there while it's going on and
sure.
Bring anything to their attention that I think needs it.
Okay. You have no objection to if the board decides to award it to O'Meara? Okay. Any discussion about this? We could tonight or in another meeting go ahead and award this to O'Meara. Anybody have any feelings or anything here? Need some discussion?
Well, I mean, I think we might as well go ahead and do it. Obviously, that would be contingent upon the grant.
Sure.
But
if there's no further discussion, if anybody wishes to make a motion to accept the engineer's recommendation of accepting that bid from O'Meara for the project, and do so at this time if they're.
I'll move to accept the engineer's recommendation and to award the bid to O'Meara.
Okay, we have a first. Anybody willing to offer up a second?
Yes.
Don Whipple will second the motion. So we have a first and a second. Is there any further discussion before we take a vote? No. Close that. Judy, voice vote, please.
Don Whipple.
Yes.
Yes.
Boris Reese?
Yes.
Bill Ursus?
Yes.
Jim Pruitt?
Yes.
John Dill?
Yes.
The next item is a authorization to sign the grant. When we receive it, we anticipate the grant will be prior to the next board meeting. There's two ways you can do it. You can have a special meeting. You'll need it turned around in probably less than 3 days. You can have a special meeting once received, or at this meeting you can take authorization to sign the grant by designated official. That's what we normally do. It is just authorization to award in the meeting, in the minutes of the meeting. And then once it's received, there's two signatures potentially. This year it may only be one, but at least the designated representative for the board will sign the document. A motion to authorize an individual on the board to sign the grant.
I motion that the president do that.
Second.
Motion second, any discussion about that? If not, all in favor of that motion, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? No, carries.
The next item, to talk about the grant, we anticipate some changes to the grant procedure. The old way, they used to reference terms and conditions, and the terms and conditions were usually the year before, the 2 years before, they referenced those terms and conditions. This year, they will be attached specifically to the grant. I have some items to change. This is a document that I will leave with you that you can peruse at your pleasure. The blue tabs, I'll leave exactly this, the blue tabs are the areas where the changes from the old terms and conditions you have already signed to the new ones that you will be signing with this grant. And I will identify just a couple of them at this point in time. The first one is that everything's going electronic, so therefore, and the city's already set up for this, but it's a system of ward management, it's called SAM for short, and it's electronic process to be able to get the grant and the money in an account through the government, federal government, and the way they can process checks to you, and a turnaround normally is about a day or two versus it used to be weeks. So that's a good thing, everything's electronic. You already have everything set up, a DUNS number. Don't ask me what that stands for. But anyhow, it's a DUNS number that you have to have and a password process that is set up, and the city's already set up for that. The other item is that basically the next one I'm talking about, the DUNS number, Data Universal Numbering System. So there you go. Then next item is specific insurances that have been added since the last step, which are technically the community was supposed to follow any out when they receive federal money, even if it's not even airport improvement money, it's some other kind of federal money. So you probably already have an insurance in a grant for this, but here they're talking about drug-free workplaces, transportation services for disabilities, and enforcement of non-discrimination and handicap. Those have been added that were not in there before. And that's pretty much all. The other one is texting. No texting while driving on the airport or any place. So that includes on the airport, not just roads. That is that. I'll leave a copy, and you can pass it on and review it however you like, or you can give it to your attorney to review because of the changes in those are legal documents that you're talking about. But however, it's non-changeable. It's a federal grant, and they won't change those conditions for you. You either don't accept the grant or accepted in those conditions. Bottom line.
It is what it is.
So, Don, you're not going to text at the airport again?
I'm sorry?
You're not going to text at the airport?
No.
Okay, since you never text anyway, same with Horace.
You're right.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The other second half of that, it's not going to start tomorrow.
All right.
But that's only one drive.
That's all I have.
That's right. Thank you, Donald. That goes through our agenda. Anybody have any comments or anything they need to bring up that's here at the conclusion of the meeting that's not on the agenda? Anything from board members? No. If not, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn this meeting.
So moved.
Don Whipple moves, we adjourn. A second? Bill Ernst, a second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay, the time is 7:41 and we're adjourned. Thank you, everyone.